conclude him in the profession part and in the business part. So you know that while we are solving the sum regarding the profession, all the admissible income we are adding it, and all the inadmissible expenses we are deducting. The income and the expenditure which are not related to my business, that we can say as inadmissible. So that thing we are not doing anything for that part. Yeah. So here, what is specified is, this specified us a cash account. Means on cash basis, what he is doing, the transaction, the income is generating, or the expenditure is doing. So according to that, we have to solve the sum and find out the taxable income of the profession. So the first is opening balance problem. No need for that. Rent of operation trader. So he is receiving rent from the operation trader. So that is the admissible income. So that part we are going to add. Consultation fees, he is receiving, he is consulting the patients and receiving the fees. It is related to his profession. We will add that part as well. Gift from the patient. Listen, gift from the patient, that is his profession income. So suppose when the operation is successful, after the patient is giving gift to him. So that is his profession part. So that part is also we should add it. So rupees 20,000. Gift received from relative on his birth. So here the word used relative, not the patient. Patient are his customers, relatives are not his customers. So that we are not going to include that part. Sales of medicines. So he is selling the medicine. So that is the income part. So we are going to add that as well. Sales of the surgical equipment. Sales of what? The surgical equipment. So here, if the person is selling the surgical equipment, so if he is receiving, so that is the profit and loss that will be calculated into the capital gain, not here. Now, next clause is bank interest. We are not going to include interest on deposit. We are not going to include that part. Now, the next part. So by hospital rent, he is paying the hospital rent, obviously. That amount should be deducted. Hospital expenses, that amount also should be deducted. Life insurance premium. He has used the word life insurance premium. So that we can't include because it is his personal life insurance. Investment in public provident fund. So that part he is investing in ETF. He is doing expense for that. We are not going to include that. Fire insurance premium, the two part, one is hospital and residence. So hospital part we are going to include, residence part we are not going to include. Municipal taxes, it is also divided into two parts, hospital and residence. So hospital part we are going to include. Drawings, it is his personal part, we can't say in the business expense. Purchase of medicines. Purchase of medicines, usually we are deducting it, but now at last we will find out the consumption part. We are having the sales, we are having the purchase part. Even if this specify an adjustment regarding the opening and closing, so we can come to know regarding the consumption. Purchase is my expenditure, but some medicine may be used for the further time for the next assessment year. So we are going to calculate only the consumption part. How much it is consumed, for that expense we are doing. Purchase of surgical equipment. So it is purchased on 1st January. So we are not going to include here in the business tax part. But for depreciation, this one information can help us. Vehicle expenses for personal, directly they are specified for personal. So we are not going to include balance carry forward. So that is not needed in this. So now the additional information I am reading. He earned salary of rupees 56,000 from the medical college. So he is earning the salary from 56,000 from medical college. So listen, this is his profession where he is guiding his client or the patient. But he is going into the medical college and taking the lectures. That will be the part of salary, not his business profession. listen carefully and explain to you everything. So, this equals to 16,250. Here plus 75,000 into 25 upon 100 into 1 by 2. So 0, 0, cut. So 750 into 25,000, so 0, 5, 2, 25, 3, 7, 0, 0. Was rupees 45,000. So this I am moving. the starting of the year. What amount of medicine you are purchasing? And the closing value is at last what amount of medicine you have. So from we are adding this, but deducting this part, we will get the consumption of medicine. That means the expense we paid on the medicine. Though we are selling the medicine, we are getting the income. But the cost expenses for that year, for that means opening is very clear. Opening value, I think, sir, 35,000. Purchase, they have specified the purchase of medicine is 110,000. And minus closing value is 45,000. So 145,000. What are 45,000 minus 45,000 that equals to 1 lakh. So this is the consumption of medicine. This is what the consumption of medicine. So this is the admissible expense. So this we can say is the note number 2. Now we are going to solve the sum. So we solve the adjustment only. Now we have to write down the admissible part and the inadmissible part. So statement of coming computation of the profession determination. Computation of taxable income from what is the name of the SEC is only profession of Mr. Sanitation fees. So the answer is going to be
part we calculated. Number two is regarding the consumption.
plus purchases minus the closing part. So we are getting the answers. Opening is 35, purchase is 110,000, and the closing is 45,000. So we call the answer 1 lakh. So deduct that part as well. So you will get the answer. After that part, we are ready. We calculate all the incomes and the expenses. After adding the incomes, we deduct the expenses. We finally got the taxable value from the profession of Mr. Bhoomi. So solve this now in the next lecture.